Welcome to our educational series on poultry health. Today we'll delve into yet another critical topic for chicken farmers and enthusiasts, infectious bronchitis in chickens. By the end of this video, you'll have a comprehensive understanding of this contagious disease and how to manage it effectively. So let's get started. Infectious bronchitis is another highly contagious disease. It's a viral disease that primarily affects chickens. It is caused by the infectious bronchitis virus, or IBV, a member of the coronavirus family. This respiratory disease targets the respiratory system, particularly the trachea and the lungs in chicken flocks. The infectious bronchitis virus is highly adaptable and can mutate rapidly, making it challenging to control. Different strains of the virus can emerge, and immunity to one strain may not protect against another. This variability is one reason why IB remains a constant threat to poultry farmers worldwide. IB spreads through various routes, including direct contact with infected birds, respiratory secretions, and feces. Indirect transmission can occur through contaminated equipment, clothing, and even wild birds and rodents. Farmers and poultry workers can unknowingly spread the virus between flocks, making biosecurity practices crucial. Identifying infectious bronchitis early is essential to limit its impact on your flock. Typical signs include sneezing, coughing, nasal discharge, swollen sinuses, and watery eyes. Chickens may appear lethargic, have decreased appetite, produce misshapen eggs, and experience a drop in egg production. All ages are susceptible, but the disease is more severe in young chicks less than 6 weeks old. In young female chicks, the impact of the virus can result in lasting damage to their reproductive system, making them susceptible to developing cystic oviducts once they begin laying eggs. For adult hens, a sudden drop in egg production lasting around 10 to 14 days is common. Additionally, they may lay eggs with thin, wrinkled or roughened shells accompanied by thin, watery albumen. Loss of pigment in brown-shelled eggs is also frequently observed. The virus's short incubation period leads to the development of clinical signs in all birds within the flock within 24 to 48 hours. Respiratory signs typically resolve within a week, unless the disease becomes complicated by co-infections with opportunistic bacteria. Proper management and proper attention to these symptoms are crucial in maintaining flock health and productivity. Accurate diagnosis of infectious bronchitis requires laboratory tests on respiratory samples, such as tracheal swabs or eye or nasal secretions. It is essential for the veterinarian to differentiate IB from other respiratory diseases like Newcastle's disease or avian influenza, as their management and control differ. Currently, no specific treatment exists for infectious bronchitis. Supportive care is crucial to help affected birds recover and to prevent those secondary infections. Isolating sick birds from the rest of the flock can limit transmission, so provide optimal nutrition, maintain a stress-free environment for the birds, and ensure good ventilation to aid in recovery. Preventing IB starts with strict biosecurity measures. Quarantine new birds. Always isolate new birds before introducing them to your main flock. Clean and disinfect equipment regularly and limit visitors' access to your farm. Implementing these practices can significantly reduce the risk of introducing IB into your flock. Vaccination can play a role in containing infectious bronchitis, so consult with your veterinarian to develop a customised vaccination strategy based on your flock's needs and regional prevalence of the virus. Vaccination can enhance flock immunity and minimise the disease's severity and economic impact. Infectious bronchitis poses a significant threat to poultry farms worldwide, But with proper knowledge, vigilant monitoring and stringent biosecurity and vaccination measures, we can protect our flocks against this highly contagious disease. So remember, early detection and prompt action are essential for managing infectious bronchitis effectively. Thank you for joining me for this educational video on infectious bronchitis in chickens. If you found this information valuable, don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe to the channel for more informative information on poultry health and husbandry. And if you have any questions or experiences to share, I'd love to hear from you. Pop them in the comments below. Until next time, happy and healthy farming.